How can this happen that two major candidates, both of whom have led the field at some point, end up not on the ballot in Virginia?
The only thing I can think of, TJ, is amateurism. Mm. And it's so interesting, I think, and appalling, frankly, that somebody like Newt Gingrich, who, as you know, has been a career politician, has been in this town for decades. And not only did he start running really early, but he was one who supposedly was very serious about this. You know, he didn't surge at the beginning, but he had a recent surge. You would think that somebody like him would be prepared to actually show up on the ballot in all 50 states, especially the state where he lives. So this is appalling. I think it's a big deal. You know, the nomination, if you want to win it, it's all about delegate selection. It's all about getting to that magic number of delegates to win the nomination. You count out a state in a race like this, and it could be over for him.
Well, Linda, she's talking about practical implications there. I mean, things that really could show up, talking about delegates, but can it turn people off, maybe even donors who are looking at this guy, Newt Gingrich or Rick Perry, and saying, wait a minute, you can't get it together? Is this amateur hour? Is this the guy I really want to be supporting?
Well, amateur is a good one, but one that has stuck to Gingrich that may be worse, and this can even go to Perry as well, is arrogance. Maybe their campaign folks took for granted that they were going to have the necessary signatures, didn't pay attention to it until it was too late, and by then, they're being reactive versus proactive to making sure that they're on the ballot. That may actually be worse, because now you're looking at a situation where they're taking certain things for granted, and the last thing you want to be as a voter is somebody that is taken for granted by a candidate. We've seen this from government for decades now, where they take for granted how we're going to go along to get along, what we should expect from our government, and how they're not going to listen to us. We're in a new day and age where we want responsive, proactive government to turn around America, and this type of messaging is not what we need from these two candidates. So this, in that regard, is a big faux pas.
Well, speaking